Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to clear the cache in AEM. That means JavaScript, JSP, HTML, Java classes and ClientLibs caching in AEM. In AEM, the elements are cached in two layers. One is dispatcher and another one is author/publisher itself. The dispatcher layer caches the HTML, JavaScript, CSS, that means client library elements, to improve the page loading time for the end user. The dispatcher cache can be cleared on page publish by configuring the flush agent in author/publisher, but it is recommended to be configured in publisher. Now I created a dispatcher flush agent in publisher under this agents on publish, dispatcher flush you can see. So let me show those configurations. So it's like serialization type, dispatcher flush, select the enabled checkbox. So then transport, I kept this dispatcher URL. My dispatcher is running on 80, so localhost 80, then dispatcher/invalidate.cache, then keep the admin username password. So other things you can leave it default, extended and all those things. In triggers you select this ignore default and on modification. So once then again you select no versioning. So once this is configured, you can click on OK. So this will enable this flush agent. So now whenever you activate publish any page to the publisher from author, so in turn it will trigger a invalidation request to dispatch. Now let me activate a page from author. Now I am an author, so I am going to activate this EN page under that B retail US. So I am just activating. Yeah, now my activation time changed to my local time 2101. So already I have configured a default replication agent in author. So if I refresh that access log, yeah, it shows the content be retail US EN successful on replication. So it looks to be it's already activated to the time, also showing the latest time. It's already activated to publisher. So now if I go to this publisher, publisher, maybe let me show before that replication agent configuration also, so that. So this is the default agent I was referring. So it's with all default values. So serialization type default. In transport I given my publisher URL, then admin username password, then triggers I selected on modification. So now this particular page is activated to publisher. If I go to the publisher dispatcher flush, so it's already received the content, and also this dispatcher flush would have triggered, the agent would have triggered. Now I'll go to the view log. So if I go to that end, so now I can see, yeah, the same time there is a replication or like invalidation request also triggered. If I so do that, maybe. Yeah, so here. Yeah, so same time, yeah, to localhost 80, dispatcher invalidate.cache, invalidation request sent to the dispatcher. Okay, now I will go to the cache folder in dispatcher. This is my cache folder, cache local. So if you see here, some of my contents are cached, content, etc, etc.clientlibs. There is a file called .stat. It's like it's a 0 KB file. So then it is recently modified at 10.3. So means whenever I activate a content in my author, so publisher send a invalidation request through that agent. Then the same time the .stat file in the cache is updated. So let's see, like the stat file updated here. Now if I go inside content, there is another .stat file that also got updated at the same time. If I again go inside bretail, there is another cache file, the same time it got updated. If I go to ES, there is no .stat file. Why? Because this .stat file is created based on the .stat file level configured in the form file. Okay, my case, the dot, the stat file level is configured as 2. It means 0, 1, 2, 3 levels. So that is the reason you were seeing the 3 folder level that dot stat file was created. Now, what does that mean? The activation invalidated all the files in the cache, and also deleted the actual activated file. What does that mean is, like, we go to content, we retail us, there is no en.html now available because that file got created, because that is the particular file got created. Again, all other files are invalidated. So based on this dot stat file update, what does that mean is, then when the dot stat file is updated, whenever next request comes in, the server compares the file timestamp with this dot stat file timestamp. If the file is older or like older, so it will get a new file and serve to the customer request. Now this invalidation is configured in the dispatcher in the form file configuration. Okay, there is in dispatcher form file configuration under cache, this is the dot slash cache, there is a section invalidate. So this is defined with some rules. What this is saying is globe star type deny. So I am denying invalidation of all the files. So it means, so it will not invalidate any of the files. Whenever there is activation, only that activated file will be removed. So as I already shown, the en.html was missing in the cache, but the dot stat file will not get updated because I am saying don't invalidate any of the file. So, but again, my next rule says star.html allow. So I means I am saying invalidate all the star.html. If whenever there is activation, go and invalidate all my HTML files. So what is the use of this is, like, you have a file, parent file, then there is a lot of child relationship. So if you are modifying one of the file, you want to invalidate all the dependent file. So then those scenarios, this invalidation help you. So that is the configuration. Based on this configuration, the dot stat file is updated and dependent files are invalidated. Okay, now the file is invalidated, the file is deleted, the particular file is deleted, although dot stat files are updated, that means dependent files are invalidated. Now, when the moment you invoke the content in the next time, so the updated content will be retrieved from the publisher and it will get cached to the dispatcher cache. Okay, let me access this page now. Content, vretail, us, en.html, I am accessing via my dispatcher. Yeah, so now I access this page, I will go to this cache. Yeah, if you see, this new file is created, en. So this HTML file, that time is 10:10, is my local time. Now also, if you go to inside en, see this file also, the JCR content, the dependent file also got updated. Why? Because it was already invalidated. So if any files enter this, yeah, this, so some of the files are already invalidated, HTML files and all those things. So that is the reason this folder time got changed. Yeah, now what we have seen is like invalidating the file, but there is another option. So some cases you don't want to invalidate, let's say like you want to activate some DAM assets and all those scenarios, you may not want to invalidate the complete cache. So there is another option, resource only cache flushing. So that can be used only to flush the particular file. So what it will do is, it will delete that particular file, but it will not update the dot stat file, or it will not invalidate the dependent resources. I have another video for that. I will be posting this URL to the description so that you can refer that. So the next one is AEM author slash publisher. AEM author slash publisher caches some of the items like JSP, like HTLR, Sitely, HTML and Java classes, some JavaScripts. So those items are getting even cached in like author or publisher level. Now let's see how to clear those items from author or publisher. So I will be showing the steps required to clear those items in author slash publisher. Okay, to clear the JSP caching, compiled JSPs, so access this particular configuration page. So it's in system console, sling JSP. There is an option called recompile all JSPs. You can just click on the recompile all JSPs. So it will recompile all the JSP files. So means it will remove the files, then it will be generated when you are requesting next time. So all compiled JSP files are removed now. So this will help. Sometimes the generated JSP might have corrupted or something, so and it will create some problems. During that time we can use this option to remove those compiled JSPs. To clear the HTL or sitelead, HTML component code and the JavaScript, so you can access this page, the configuration page. It's under system console, script cache. So this will list out all these cached HTML, means sitely or HTL component HTML. Also some of the sitely related JavaScript, component related JavaScript and all HTML. So here you have two options. One is like you can remove this individually, remove option can be clicked, or there is another option, clear cache. So when the moment you click on clear cache, complete cache will be cleared. Or like you can remove one by one, like whatever the files you require, it can be removed. Yeah, so that particular file is removed from the cache. Now the next one is like how to invalidate the cache for the client libraries, and also like how to rebuild those libraries. So for that you can access this particular URL. It's under libs granite UI content dump libs.rebuild.html. So there are two options are available. So invalidate caches, rebuild libraries. So the moment you click invalidate caches, it will invalidate all the client libraries, whatever the client libraries already created. So it's saying like clearing where clean libs, it's done. So now you can click on the rebuild client libraries, but it is going to take time because like it has to rebuild all the client libraries. It may take some long time. So, but I'll just click it. Yeah, it will rebuild all the libraries. Yeah, now we cleared the client library cache and also the JSP cache, and we seen how the HTML component, the sitely HTML component cache can be cleared. Now the last option is how to clear the Java classes and sitely classes. So for that, I am into this system console bundles. Search for Apache Sling Commons File System Class Loader. Just to note this bundle ID, it's 470. Now go to the CRX Quick Start folder, the installation folder. Under that there is a folder called Launchpad, then Felix. So go to that particular bundle, whatever we have seen already. It is 470, so I will go to that particular bundle, 470. Yeah, there is a folder called data, then there is a folder called classes. This is the folder stores all those classes. You see apps, retail, components, content, article list. Yeah, there is a dot class file and Java class corresponding. So to clear the cache, what you can do is you can just go and delete this folder. So it will be obviously it will be recreated by recompiling those classes. That's all for today. In this video, we have learnt how to clear the AEM cache from dispatcher, and also the caching maintained in author/publisher. Thanks all for watching the video.